So suppose in DSBSC, so I told you this is how we generate. How we generate? Very simple thing. Just multiplying two things. This is message signal M of T. This is carrier C of T. This is X of T. That is a modulated signal. That is simply M of T into C of T. So this is called product modulator. So X of T is, we can write M of T into, what is C of T? Obviously, it is always AC cos omega CT. So what is mod of X of T would be? If take mod to this, what do you get? You get mod of M of T. So what is the envelope of the signal? Obviously, mod of M of T, not M of T. So that's why envelope is proportional to mod of M of T. That's why we may not use envelope detector for demodulation. So then instead of this, what do we use? We use something called synchronous or coherent detector or demodulator. Coherent demodulator. This is called coherent demodulator. So what do you mean by coherence or synchronous? Now this is a modulator. You're transmitting X of T. You transmit over a channel. What do you receive here? So X of T you receive. It is a receiver side. Again, we multiply with cos omega CT. So this is called local carrier. What it is called? Local carrier. And after that, so this product X of T into cos omega CT will be passed through a low pass filter whose bandwidth is W. What is W actually? Bandwidth of message signal. Now what do you get here? Something proportional to M of T. You may get some amplitude, AC by 2 or AM by 2. Now, so we have two carriers. At the receiver side, we have a local carrier. At the transmitter side, we have an incoming carrier. It is called incoming carrier. What is C of T? C of T is AC cos omega CT. That is incoming carrier. What is local carrier? Also same. So the local carrier and incoming carrier are synchronized. In both terms, what are they? Synchronized in frequency and phase, or they have phase and frequency coherence. So that's what is called coherent or synchronous demodulator. Okay. Now here, if you observe the modulator demodulator, what is a modulator? Multiplier. So what a demodulator? It's still a multiplier. The only extra thing is we have a low pass filter. So there is no much difference between modulation and demodulation. Both are multipliers. And the demodulator, we use an extra filter, that is low pass filter, to remove the unwanted frequencies. Okay. Here, so it is a little bit complex. Okay. Why? Because in the receiver, we have to generate what carrier? Local carrier. You have to generate a carrier in the receiver side. It is quite difficult because this carrier should have same frequency, same phase as that of incoming carrier that we use in the modulation. So this would be a little bit complex. Okay. But in ED, there is no such requirement. What is ED? This circuit is there, which is containing some basic elements. So if you give input to the circuit, you're getting output. There you're not generating any carrier. Okay. So that's why it is very simple. But here, you have to generate a carrier, you have to multiply with it. So this multiplication also not so easy. It is analog multiplication. It is very difficult. Okay. So compared to ED, this is complex. Okay. But here, DSBSC cannot be demodulated by ED. That's why you have to go for this synchronous or coherent demodulator. So we have seen this is the synchronous demodulator. This is output. Yeah, all the things I explained. What happens if there is a loss of phase synchronization? What do you get? You get apart from m of t, you get cos theta, which is something like attenuation. But this theta should never be pi by 2. If it is pi by 2, you get zero output. That is called null effect. Okay. Now this is what the phase mismatch. So here the carrier is having phase of theta, but at the carrier at the input side is having zero phase. So this is error. This is a mismatch in the phase. Then what happens here? You get extra term cos theta, which is nothing but attenuation, because cos theta is always be always less than one. Mod of cos theta is always less than one. It is some kind of attenuation. But remember, when theta equal to pi by 2 or 90 degrees, you get zero output. That should be avoided. That is called null effect. Now here, so as I told you, there could be a phase mismatch and frequency mismatch. Suppose if there is a both mismatches, frequency mismatch and phase mismatch. So this is output now. This is output. Apart from m of t, ideally you should get m of t, but you are getting m of t into cos 2 pi delta f t plus theta. What is delta f? The frequency error. What is theta? Phase error between two carriers. Now we are getting this extra term, which is unwanted term. Okay. If at all there is a small difference in the frequency and phase of the two carriers, now this would be the output. Okay, that's why you must have a synchronization between frequency and phases of two carriers. That is essential. Is it okay? So that's why I told you it is a little bit complex to implement. Analytically, it may look simpler, but when you go for practical implementation, you may get so many problems like this: phase mismatch, frequency mismatch. Okay, right. So that is one of the drawbacks of DSBSC. Okay, now, so we go for next modulation technique, that is called SSB, single sideband modulation, or SSBSC, single sideband suppressed carrier. Now we are, what we do? So in AM, we had in the spectrum, we had carrier and two sidebands. In DSBSC, we have suppressed the carrier. We had only transmitted two sidebands. Now what I do? I will transmit only one sideband. Either we transmit upper sideband or lower sideband. Then it is called single sideband suppressed carrier. We are suppressing the carrier, and also we are suppressing one of the sidebands. Okay. So by doing so, do we lose any information? No. As I told you, two sidebands are identical in nature. They contain same information. Each sideband contains complete information about. Each sideband contains complete information about m of t. So as somebody rightly pointed out, bandwidth becomes W. Okay. So we are improving the efficiency. Bandwidth efficiency, or also called as spectral efficiency. Okay, so we transmit only one sideband, either upper sideband or lower sideband, because they are identical. So how to do that? This is the graph. Okay, so let us go to the graph. What do we do first? What is this graph? This part. What is this part? This is a DSB, double sideband. First, we generate double sideband. How to generate a double sideband? Just multiply m of t and c of t. After that, so this is, so before that, let me go to this. This is a message signal, m of f. This is a spectrum of message signal. So it is starting from zero. Please remember, this is a message signal which is starting from zero, having a bandwidth W. Okay, this is a maximum amplitude of this spectrum. You can take one, no problem. Now if that is a message spectrum, this is a DSB spectrum having two sidebands. Now in SSB, we have to transmit only one sideband, which means we have to remove any one of the sidebands. Now what I do is I will pass this spectrum through high pass filter with a cutoff frequency fc. So this is the ideal high pass filter. Okay. So what happens now? What is removed? If you pass this through high pass filter, what is removed? this lower sidebands are removed. What will you get? You will get only this portion. This portion will be transmitted through the filter, which means lower sidebands are suppressed. This is what you get. This is SSB with ESB. That is one method. Or you can do another way. What is the way? If I pass this through low pass filter, what will happen? Low pass filter means this is the low pass filter. So what are transmitted? Lower side bands are transmitted and upper side bands are removed. So this is what you get. Okay, this is a simple generation. First generate DSBSC. Okay, pass through high pass filter, you get single side band, that is upper side band. That is one way. But another way, you pass this through low pass filter with a cutoff frequency fc, you get lower side bands. Upper side bands are removed. Okay, simple method. But what is the problem here? The problem is, can you tell me what is the problem here? What problem do you face? Anyone? What is the problem? The problem is, here I have taken a low pass filter, high pass filter, which are idle in nature. Idle means they have a sharp cutoff frequencies. They are sharp. You can see very clearly. I have taken sharp cutoff frequencies, but they are unrealizable because they are idle in nature. Why idle filters are not realizable? They are because they are non-causal. Okay, so if you take idle filters only, this is output. Please remember this. The drawback of this method is the filters need to be ideal with sharp cutoff frequencies or with a sharp fall off. If they are not ideal, suppose if they are something like this. Ideal, if they are not ideal, means they have some transitions like this. They won't be having sharp cutoffs. They will be gradually rolling off like this. Then what happens? You don't get this output. What do you get? Okay, you get something else. Okay, that comes later. But so as of now, this is one of the methods to generate SSB. The drawback of this method is filters need to be ideal. Okay, please remember, this is a message signal which is starting from zero. Okay, so sorry, this is my interview, right? This is called frequency discrimination method. This method of generating SSB is called frequency discrimination. Okay. Yeah, these are the two spectrum of SSB. Either you pass upper sideband or lower sideband. Obviously, bandwidth will be only W. That is same as message bandwidth. Now we are saying bandwidth and power also. Okay, so both are come down. So we are saving bandwidth and power. Correct. So this is very good. But so implementation will be very very difficult. Okay, as I mentioned just now, we need ideal filters to separate two sidebands. That is the question. Okay. So generation. Obviously, so I just now told you, first generate DSBSC. How? Just multiply MRP and CRP. After that, use high pass filter, you get upper side band. Or use low pass filter, you get lower side band. Both are all right. Okay. So because either you transmit upper or lower side band, we don't have any problem because both are identical in nature. Both carries complete information about MRP. Okay. Right. Okay. So that is about that. Next, yeah, so we'll discuss something called Hilbert transform. Something is very very important, that is called Hilbert transform. The name itself, Hilbert transform. So x of t is the signal. Hilbert transform, we call it as x hat, h a t hat, x hat of t, or sometimes you can also denote with x h of t. This is a notation. Okay. Now, so you might have known Fourier transform, Laplace transform, Z transform. In the same way, we have one more transform that is called Hilbert transform. But it is quite different from them. Okay. In what way it is different from them? So let us see. Yeah, this is notation x hat of t. Now this is a duality. Okay, signum function. You know signum function, right? Signum of t. This is signum function. What is the signum function? Do you recall? It is 1 for t greater than 0. It is minus 1 for t less than 0. Is it okay? Now signum function is a Fourier transform of 1 by j pi f. So 1 by pi t will have a Fourier transform of minus j signum of f. This is called duality principle. You go and verify what is the duality principle. Okay, x of t, x of omega, capital X of t equal to x of minus omega. Okay, so I don't want to get into details. So as I already mentioned, you must be thorough with the basics of Westenders. Okay, I don't want to waste my time. You, if you have any doubts, you go and check after the class. Okay, so this is a duality. So simply here, 1 by pi t as a Fourier transform of minus j sigma of f. Okay, now, so the impulse response of Hilbert transform is 1 by pi t. Now this is what the Hilbert transform. So if you pass x of t through this filter or system with impulse response 1 by t, you get x hat of t. Obviously, what is x hat of t now? So simply, the Hilbert transform is defined as x hat of t equal to, how it is defined? Equal to x of t convolution 1 by pi t. X of t convolution 1 by pi t. X of t convolution 1 by pi t. So by using Fourier transform property, convolution in time domain becomes product in the frequency domain. What is x at of f? X of f into, this is into now. Okay. What is the Fourier transform 1 by pi t? Minus j signum of f. So it is into minus j signum of f. Now, so this is what we have, 1 by pi t convolution x of t. This is a notation of convolution. What is the convolution formula we write generally? What do we write generally convolution? Suppose if I say x of t convolution h of t. What is the formula? Integration minus 2 plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. Correct? The same way we have written that formula. Correct? Right. Now, so let us. Now, what is written? X at of t equal to. So, in the same way, what do you write? Minus 2 plus infinity x of tau. What is h of t now? 1 by pi t. 1 by pi t means h of t minus tau. 1 by pi into t minus tau d tau. You can further write this as 1 by pi is outside, 1 by pi minus 2 plus infinity x of tau by t minus tau d tau. This is the final formula of Hilbert transform. Same thing is being explained here. I have written alpha. Anything is okay. So, but you must remember this important thing. Two things are very, very important. These two things. Okay. Now, this is what I want to try to explain. So, this signum of f, this is minus x signum of f. What is minus j sigma of f? How you write this as? It is minus j whenever frequency is greater than 0. It is plus j whenever frequency is negative. Is it okay? Plus j. That is a minus j sigma of f function. Yes. Yeah. So here mathematically, what do we write here is mathematically we write like this. What is minus j sigma of f is indicating? Minus j sigma of f is giving these concepts. It is minus j for positive frequency, j for negative frequency. So generally j means what is the phase of j? Pi by 2 or 90 degrees. So mathematical what we say for negative frequencies, for negative frequencies, what is we can write? Minus pi by 2 for negative frequencies. Pi by 2 phase shift for positive frequencies. This is the job of the Hilbert transform. It is providing a phase shift of minus pi by 2 for positive frequencies, a phase shift of pi by 2 for negative frequencies. Sorry. Did I make any mistake? Or minus j for positive frequencies. It is for negative frequencies. Correct? Okay. Minus pi by 2 for positive frequencies, pi by 2 for negative frequencies. Okay. Now, but mathematically, what we can say? It is very, very important. Observe this carefully. Mathematically, I will say that for all frequencies, it is introducing a phase shift of how much? Minus pi by 2. Whether it is positive or negative, it is having a phase shift of minus pi by 2. Can I say like this? Why? Because if it is positive, minus pi by 2. Negative pi by 2. That's why mathematically for all frequencies, I can say that it is having a phase shift of minus pi by 2 or minus 90 degrees. So that is the job of the Hilbert transform. I mentioned very clearly, Hilbert transform can be obtained by simply shifting the phase of each and every frequency component by minus 90 degrees, irrespective of sign of the frequency. Okay. This is how mathematically we define Hilbert transform. It is a ideal phase shift of minus pi by 2 for all frequencies. Is it okay? Any doubts here? You can ask me. So this is one of the important things you must remember. Is it okay? Okay. So you only remember Hilbert transform means phase shift of minus pi by 2. That's it. But Hilbert transform does not change the domain. This is one of the very important things you must know. Why? Because I have clearly mentioned here, x of t, Hilbert transform x hat of t, both are time domains. It does not change the domain, but what about remaining transforms? If you take Fourier transform, for Fourier transform, what do you write? What do you write? X of t, Fourier transform, x of f. It is changing the domain from time to frequency or frequency to time. Okay. Every other transform changes the domain except Hilbert. It does not change the domain. Time domain to time domain only. It only changes the phase by minus pi by 2. That's it. So even though it is transform, but it does not change the time domain. It does not change the domain. So Hilbert transform constant is 0. Why it is 0? You find out. Okay. Now, what is Hilbert transform of sine 2 pi f c t? How to find out? Just now I told you, suppose you have sine 2 pi f c t. What do? You add a phase of minus 90 degrees. What is this? Sine 2 pi f c t minus 90 cos omega c t minus cos omega c t. In the same way, what about Hilbert transform of cos 2 pi f c t? You add a minus 90 degrees. You get sine. So to find out Hilbert transform, if there is a possibility, you just have a phase shift of minus pi by 2 or minus 90 degrees. You get the Hilbert transform. Okay. Now, so this is the DSBSC equation in time domain for multi single tone signal. Do you remember? So this is the DSBSC of a single tone signal. Upper side band, lower side band. Single tone means when m of t is am cos 2 pi fm t. Now what is a USB signal now? Only transmit either upper side band or lower side band. Okay. So these are the two equations of SSB. If you transmit upper side band, what do you get? This is amplitude anyway, cos 2 pi fc plus fmt. If you transmit lower side band, cos 2 pi fc minus fmt. These are the equations of single side band. Okay. Now, here. Okay. Now, let me consider one more thing. Very very important. Pay your attention. Let us take x of t equal to m of t cos omega c t minus m hat of t sin omega c t. I am taking this equation. Okay, you just follow my equation. That's it. Okay, here what I am saying is I have taken this equation x of t. So if m of t equal to cos 2 pi fm t, I am not writing am ac, you forget that, cos 2 pi m of t is cos 2 pi fm t. What is m hat of t? That means Hilbert transform of m of t. What is Hilbert transform of cos 2 pi fct? Sin 2 pi fct. In the same way, the Hilbert transform of cos 2 pi fmt is what? Sin 2 pi fmt. Now what about x of t now? X of t would be x of t equal to m of t into cos omega ct. M of t cos omega ct means cos 2 pi fmt, that is m of t into cos omega ct into cos omega ct minus what is m hat of t? Sin 2 pi fmt. Into sin omega ct. Sin 2 pi fmt into sin omega ct. What is this x of t now? It is like cos 2 pi fmt cos omega ct minus sin 2 pi fmt sin omega ct. Something like cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Something like cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. What is this? Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. It is cos a plus b. It is something like cos a plus b. But what is a? What is b? This is a. This is b. Omega ct means 2 pi f ct. Which means what is x of t would be now? Cos a plus b 2 pi into fc plus fmt. What is that above equation is called? Anyone will answer? What is this is called? Hmm? Yeah, that is simply upper side band. As just now told you, this is upper side band, cos 2 pi fc plus fmt. Forget about this amplitude, okay? Which means this is SSB with upper side band. So that becomes x upper side band. But what is that equation I have started with? What is that? M of t cos omega c t. M of t cos omega c t minus m hat of t sin omega c t. So this is the time domain equation of SSB by transmitting upper side band. Suppose in the same equation, if I take reverse, if I keep it place, what happens? Here you get place. What happens? Here you get place. Cos A cos B plus sin A sin B is what? Cos A minus B. What happens? This becomes minus. If that is minus, what is becomes? Lower side band. Okay, please remember. This becomes plus. Yeah, upper side band. So what about lower side band equation now? M of t cos omega c t plus m hat of t sin omega c t. These are the two equations of SSB. If you transmit upper side band, this is the equation. So if at all if you transmit the lower side band, this is the equation. So one more, the only thing you must remember is the basic equation. What a basic equation? These are basic equations. So if you keep minus here, you're getting upper side band. So if you keep plus here, you're getting lower side band. Okay, don't get confused. Generally people think that if you keep plus here, you get upper side band. If you keep minus, you get lower side band. No, it's reverse. If you keep minus here, you're getting upper side band. If you keep plus here, you're getting lower side band. So this is the final equation of SSB. So if you keep minus here, you'll get upper side band. If you keep plus here, you get lower side band, reverse. Now these are the two equations for, two time domain equations for single side band modulation. Either you can modulate, you can transmit upper side band or lower side band. This is the final equation. I keep plus or minus. If I say plus, lower side band. If I say minus, upper side band. Okay. Now this is how we are generating the generation. How to implement this equation? First, you take m of t. I'm taking m of t. Okay. Yeah. I'm taking m of t. You take m of t. We need m of t as well as m hat of t. Okay, so m of t goes here. M of t is multiplied with cos 2 pi fc t. This is cos 2 pi fc t. M of t is multiplied with cos 2 pi fc t. What do you get here? M of t cos 2 pi fc t. Now I'm applying m of t to the Hilbert transform. You get m hat of t here. And one more thing is cos 2 pi fc t here minus 90 degrees. It becomes sin 2 pi fc t. Okay. Now here m hat of t, here sin 2 pi fc t. What do you get here? M hat of t sin 2 pi fc t. So from the upper path, you get m of t cos 2 pi fc t. From the lower path, you get m hat of t sin 2 pi fc t. Here you get either plus or minus. If you take plus, you get lower side band. If you take minus, you get upper sediment. This is generation. So this is one more generation. It's called phase shifting method. I told you just now. I told you one method that is called frequency discrimination method. What are you doing there? You are generating DSBSC and removing or separating one of the sediment using filters, ideal filters. Here we are using here Hilbert transform. Is it okay? There are two methods. Generation of SSB is with two methods: frequency discrimination method, phase shifting method. The problem of frequency discrimination is ideal filters which are not realizable. Here also, the Hilbert transform ideally is not realizable. Okay, both methods are not precise. Both has got their own problems. Okay. Okay, so here I have shown one method. I have done with some. I have taken M of T cost of FCT Fourier transform. This is a Fourier transform. I have taken Hemiart FC sine to FCT Fourier transform. I have taken in frequency domain. If I subtract these two, what I get? If I add these two, what I get? This is a diagram. This is M of F. This is M hat of F. So this is the first equation, the second equation. If I subtract these two equations, I'm getting upper side bands. If I add these two equations, I'm getting lower side band. Okay, this is your under for your understanding. Okay, any doubts? You can ask me now. So with this, we'll complete single side band also. Little bit is there to discuss, but okay, so let us proceed now. Okay, as I just now told you, the generation of SSB is very difficult. There are two methods, but two methods are not precise. In the frequency discrimination method, we need ideal filters, which is unrealizable. In the phase shifting method, we have problem with Hilbert transform, ideal Hilbert transform, which is not realizable. Why it is not realizable? Because the Hilbert transform phase shifts requires an abrupt phase change of pi at a zero frequency. Okay, here just now I told you Hilbert transform 1 by pi t. This is a minus j sigma of f. The Fourier transform, Hilbert transform is like this. Here at zero frequency, here at this frequency, there is a discontinuity. Okay, so suddenly phase changes from minus j to plus j. Minus j means minus pi by 2. It should go to pi by 2. Plus pi by 2, minus pi by 2, plus pi by 2. Suddenly at zero frequency, there should be a phase change of pi, because it should go from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. How much is the shift? Pi. So there is a discontinuity at zero frequency. There should be abrupt phase change of pi radians or 180 degrees. So that is not ideally realizable. So that is the problem of second method, that is phase shifting method. In the first method, the problem is having ideal filters. So both are not precise. Ideal filters, ideal Hilbert transform. Okay, but so there is an inherent property. What is that is? These two problems are eliminated if and only if the baseband signal spectrum may have very little power near origin. Okay, note down this. If the baseband message signal or message spectrum has a little power near origin. Okay, what does it mean? Means here I have taken, this is the spectrum of my baseband signal. It has got more power near origin. near zero frequency. So, but here, what is the requirement? It should not have power at zero frequency. Means, so in the first class, I have discussed, okay, what I have discussed, we have a variety of information sources like video signal. What is a video signal? It starts from what frequency to what frequency? Video signal. It starts from where to where? Anyone? It starts from
0 to 4.5 megahertz.
Which means it has got some power at zero. It's starting from zero. Correct? Now, so suppose you take voice. It starts from where? Not from zero. It starts from 300 hertz to 3.3 kilohertz. Which means if I draw the spectrum of voice signal, how it would be? It does not start from zero, instead starts from 300, goes to 300, this is 3300. Same thing this side also. It is voice or speech. How much gap is there from origin? We have a gap of around 300 hertz. Is it okay? This is origin. If the baseband signal has no power at origin, the baseband spectrum has no power at origin, then there is no problem. Why? Okay, we call it as null at DC. It is having null at DC. Null means zero. DC means what frequency? Zero frequency. At zero frequency, there should not be anything. It should not have any power or any significant components. Only at zero, it can start from some low frequencies, but at zero, it should not have anything. Why? Because if it is having no power at zero frequency, we don't have any problem with Hilbert transform. Why? Because in Hilbert transform, what is the problem? At zero frequency, we have a discontinuity, but at other frequencies, we don't have any problem. Only at zero frequency, there is a discontinuity where we need to have a abrupt change of pi radians. So at zero frequency, if there is no power in our message signal, we don't have any problem. We can realize this ideal Hilbert transform. Okay, that is a one advantage. What is another advantage? If the spectrum is like this, okay, we'll discuss later. Okay, now, so for SSB to transmit, the requirement is our baseband spectrum should have a little power at origin. Am I okay with this? Okay. Obviously, you cannot transmit video signals by using SSB because it starts from zero, so SSBs cannot be generated. Okay. Now, so we'll give some details about this later. As of now, this is enough. Okay. Don't worry. Now, what about demodulation of SSB? It's just like DSBSC. What is demodulation of SSB? Just like coherent demodulation or synchronous demodulation, where again we multiply our modulated signal with carrier and pass through low pass filter. Same thing. This is the S of T, multiply with the local carrier, pass through low pass filter, you get AC by 2 M of T. Again, we have a problem of loss of synchronization. What synchronization? It could be a loss of phase synchronization or frequency synchronization. I told you about these things. So there are two carriers. One is at the transmitter side, another is at the receiver side. If they have mismatches in the frequencies and phases, obviously that is a problem to us. Now, if there is a mismatch in the phase and frequency, there is a problem. Here, I am explaining about phase mismatch. This is what you get. Okay. So, in case of DSBSC, what do you got? You got only this term. AC by 2 m of t cos theta. But in case of SSB, you're getting extra term is this r minus AC by 2 m hat of t sin theta. Okay, this means SSB is very much sensitive to phase variations compared to DSBSC. Because it is not only affecting amplitude, it is affecting everything. Okay, obviously, we always try to maintain phase and frequency synchronization while demodulating. Okay, is it okay? So, not only term of cos theta will appear, but also term containing Hilbert transform also appearing. We are getting term containing Hilbert transform also. In SSB, if there is a phase mismatch, this is a problem. It is more severe compared to the DSBSC. Okay. Yeah. So let us go to the single sideband modulation is well suited for transmission of speech because of energy gap that exists in the spectrum of the speech signal between 0 and few hundred hertz. Just now I mentioned this is the spectrum of speech signal which has a null at DC or very low power at zero frequency. Now we have energy gap of how much? 300 hertz. This is the m of f. It does not exactly start from origin, but where about video? It exactly starts from origin. Okay, so video signal cannot be transmitted by using single sideband. Okay, that is a problem actually. But so when it comes to speech or voice, it is okay. Can you tell me another signal which does not start from zero, exactly from zero? What is that? Anyone? Audio, yes. Audio also does not start from zero. It starts from where? 20. Which means we have an energy gap of 20 from origin. Why it is so important? As I told you, when it comes to Hilbert transform, we don't have a discontinuity problem because at zero nothing is there. We don't have any problem at zero. But what about first method? Frequency discrimination method. Okay. Yeah. So now this is the spectrum of what signal? Can you tell me? This is m of f. Okay. What is this now? What is spectrum of this signal? What it is called? What is this spectrum? We'll tell the answer. It is spectrum of which modulation? I've discussed three modulations: AM, DSBSC, SSB. If this is m of f, what is this signal? What is this spectrum? What is this? This is DSBSC. What happened? This is shifted towards the left side and right side by FC. Isn't it? Yes or not? Okay. But here, you don't get confused. Okay. So this is the upper side band. This is the lower side band. What is your observation here? What is observation? Okay. So if you go back to the spectrum of DSBSC that we discussed, okay, what observation? What is other? What difference between this and this? What is the difference? Both are spectrums of DSBSC only. What is the difference? What difference did you observe between these two spectrums? The difference is upper sideband and lower sidebands are separated here. They are not touching each other. They have a gap of how much? 600 hertz. Between them, we have a gap of how much? 600 hertz. But here, we don't have any gap. They are touching each other. Okay. So, whenever they're touching each other, to separate them, obviously we need a ideal filters, the sharp edges, because they're touching each other. But here, since they are away from each other, separation will be very easy. How to separate? Obviously, we use a filter. Here we use a filter to separate one of the sidebands. The thing is, advantage is what? We don't need ideal filters. Why? Because suppose even though filters are a little bit transition in nature, something like this. Okay, still no problem. Why? Because they are separated in frequency. We have a gap between them. Here also, if the filter is not ideal, it is having a gradual roll off or a transition band. Something like this. If the filter is like this, let me take. Okay. Still, we don't have any problem. Even though filters are not ideal, still you can able to separate sidebands. Because they are not touching each other. Okay. So, whenever baseband spectrum has little power at zero frequency, SSB is good. For speech and audio, SSB is good. But video, you cannot generate that. Because, see, so this is a spectrum of DSBSC if what? If M of T is like this, if M of F is like this, if M of F is like this. If this is M of F, what happens? Spectrums shifted to left side, right side by FC. So we have a upper sideband, lower sideband, which are touching each other. To separate them, we need ideal filters. But if at all they have a gap of 600 hertz, it is enough to have a normal filters where they have a roll off. But even though you roll off, you can able to separate them. Okay. Right, so that is about SSB. What else we can require is, yeah. Yeah, so when the message signal contains significant components with extremely low frequencies, as in the case of television video signal, the upper and lower sidebands meet at their carrier frequency, yeah, like this. So video signal, you take video signal, So if you take the spectrum of that video signal, and if you observe phase-based spectrum, lower sideband, upper sideband are meeting each other. So it would be very difficult to separate them, because we need ideal or sharp cutoff frequencies. Okay, that is a problem, correct? Okay, so that is about SSB. In SSB, we have a bandwidth of W only, correct? It is suitable for transmitting voice or audio signal, voice and audio signals. Okay, any doubts? It's okay then, right? Stop here.